Thank you so much for tuning back in, and in this video, I'll be going over basic running mechanics and tips to use on the hammer, so don't go anywhere. The first portion of this video, I'm going to cover basic running mechanics. Things like posture, foot position, arm swing, cadence, and stride. All these factors belong to another category called gait. There's a lot more to gait than just these four components, but for what I've seen with the airmen, these are what they need to focus on the most. So when these basics are learned, the airmen will complete more shuttles and achieve a better score on the hammer. Question out there for everyone. You know, if you have a good posture when you sit, how's your posture when you run? If you're not sitting up straight when you're seated, then you may have poor posture. A lack of core and abdominal strength are potentially the culprits. So, do you know how your body is positioned when you walk, when you jog, when you run? How about when you sprint? Is there any pain at any point of your stride? If there is, then you're probably not getting much enjoyment out of running, so you're not going to put that much effort in trying to get better at it. So, good running posture maintains a slight forward lean. While maintaining this forward lean, it helps your foot land underneath you instead of out in front. So the more upright posture you have, the greater chance of a heel strike for that foot to come out more. So it's not that heel striking is bad, it's just not as efficient as a midfoot landing. So think about it more as a controlled fall. When you run, your foot that impacts the ground should land more neutral and not overly pronate or supinate. So this neutral positioning is to help distribute the force evenly across your shoe when your foot lands and not place as much sharp impact forces on the lower leg. If your running posture is too upright, then your heel may strike and not achieve this neutral foot landing. The more often you heel strike, the more braking forces are placed on your body and a result is a decreased forward momentum. A slight forward lean to your running posture gives you a better chance that your foot will land directly underneath you. Landing this way will help decrease the impact forces on your body that would otherwise be there with a heel strike. Landing the foot with more pronation or supination may show a lack of ankle and lower leg strength, which could lead to a greater risk of injury. Such injuries may include an ankle sprain or strain if this imbalance isn't caught early on. Some ankle and lower leg strengthening exercises will help decrease the likelihood of twisting an ankle during the run or the hammer. I'll go over those strengthening exercises more in another video. One basic mechanic that would help out everybody is arm swing. Contralateral arm swing will improve your stride and running economy. The better arm swing, the better hip extension you'll have while you're running. I'll put the study link in the description below if you have an interest. In this biology study, they have evidence to support there is more energy cost in less arm swing as opposed to more arm swing. There's a greater locomotive demand on the pelvis, shoulders, and trunk to rotate with restricting arm movement. Basically, with less arm swing, you're causing yourself to run out of gas a lot quicker. You'll have better hip extension and more energy during your run with better arm swing. I'll go over more arm swing in another video on this series. So, arm swing is very important because you don't want to go running around like a T-Rex. Another great study I found was for cadence and stride. An effective cadence and stride can decrease injury and pain. So I'll put the link to this study in the description below as well. And in this research article, the authors show that an increase of 5% to an individual's normal run cadence has a reduction of impact forces across the entire body and feet, as opposed to a little shorter normal cadence of the runner. Basically, the short choppy steps will increase your run time and the amount of forces that you place on your body. So there is an optimal running cadence and stride length that everyone has. And all you need to do is open up your hips a little bit more. So try to work on a good toe off and more hip extension, and it'll help increase your pace and use less energy. So here's some tips to use on the hammer. Land and take off facing the same way. This method is to provide your body with symmetry and not to create an imbalance from turning around and around. Start out slow and gauge yourself. Don't go hard right out the gate. This is a quick test, so if you expel all your energy, then you won't have anything left, you know, to get those shuttles at the back end. Work on proper mechanics early. If you work on those basics early, then you'll improve your hammer score. no doubt. So don't forget to practice. And unless you're a gifted young athlete, you probably need to practice the hammer a few times. So when I first started doing the hammer myself, I didn't do so well, but after a couple times for practicing and getting everything set up, I'm doing pretty well. So my scores went up just from practicing, and it'll help you too. If you have any questions thus far, hey, put them in the comments below. I like to hear what everybody thinks about the hammer, and if you see something that can help out, hey, let us know. Let's get on the fast path to success. So on the next video, I'm going to go over advanced sprinting mechanics. Thank you so much for watching. See you next time.